welcome everyone to the grand final of the FISU eSports Challenge. So today is the last day of this incredible challenge, and we are finishing that with the grand finals for both men and women. That's going to be amazing. I'm Paulo Salvador, and I'm presenting this challenge to you, and I'm so excited. I'm feeling so honored today to be here. I'm here with my great friend, Ben, the commentator. So before we start, I would like to thank everybody who worked in the background to make this challenge happen. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for that. The whole FISU, the entire organizing committee, you guys are amazing. So thank you so much, all the players as well, you know, to make this challenge even more brilliant. So, and thank you all the universities here to, supporting your players from all over the world. Hey, what's up, Ben? Good morning, right?
Great introduction, and it is well said. Thank you to everybody. Super exciting stuff. We can't wait to get going. It's sad that it all has to come to an end.
Yeah. You know, I'm going to miss you all, especially our friends from all over the world who are watching us right now. We have a lot of friends, more than 300 friends right now from Twitch. This is amazing. Thank you so much, for guys, for coming. Please keep bringing your friends, your family, everyone to watch these incredible matches today. So let me just remember you guys. We started this challenge at July 6th. So here is the last day, day 8. So today we are also going to have some special surprises, Ben. We have some highlights from some great previous matches we had in this challenge. And also, we're going to have interviews with the finalists. So you guys can know more about them by themselves. You know, that's going to be amazing. Our interviewer will be Barbara Fernandes from Brazil. She's helping Tina with the communications of this challenge. And so this is going to be really nice to know more about them by themselves before the confrontations of the finals.
Oh, that's really great.
Yeah. So any briefing overview, anything you want to say before we start with the highlights and the interviews?
No, it's quite straightforward. I mean, today there is no tomorrow. It's a huge achievement for all four players. Two players will be champions, two players will be runner up, and either way, it's such a huge honor to say that you were the champion or the runner-up of the FISU eSports Challenge 2020, the first eSports Challenge 2020. And that's something to be extremely proud of at a very young age. Yeah. And this will hopefully kickstart their career in eSports. And, you know, for some of them, this is the first time playing a major, major competition of eSports. So, you know, the first one is always memorable, regardless. Yeah. So it is a learning milestone and a milestone that will be a huge part of your life. Yeah. So that look back on and say, yeah, I was part of something special. And they are part of something special. They will always be part of something special. That's what FISU is all about.
Yeah. Truly historical moment. And you are all part of that. Thank you so much for that. So today we're going to know the best university players of eSports football. That's going to be amazing. The first eSports challenge from FISU. So let's go for the highlights, Ben. Let's start with the highlights to know some, to watch a little bit about our previous incredible matches we had in this challenge.
Let's have a look.
Hello everyone! Welcome to the FISU eSports Challenge Football!
started history in the making. And I know many of us have been sitting at home hoping for great sporting achievements or great sporting milestones to happen in 2020. But COVID-19 has put a span in the works a bit, but let's stay positive. A goal, all good save there by the keeper.
Yeah, that was really, really nice to see. There's incredible highlights, right, Ben?
Oh, no, I'm going to request for those highlights to put on my Instagram.
Yeah, I will do the same, definitely.
Yeah, so no, that was really cool. It's really memorable. The passion, the excitement. And yeah, I mean, every word that I have to describe this tournament is absolutely fantastic. I was a little bit nervous before this tournament, to be honest, Paolo, when FISU asked me to do this, because I did not know what to expect, you know, because I'm so used to rocking up to a stadium, you know, putting earphones on my head, talking to a producer and everything like that. But this is so different doing it in my living room. My children looking at me and said, why is Dada screaming and shouting with a big smile on his face to the laptop, you know. So, I mean, it's great, and that package just summed it all up. So, well done to the person who edited that package. That was very nice.
Yeah, you know, this challenge changed the whole daily routine of my family here in my place. You know, because you know I had to manage all of this. So that you can hear my birds from the background, you can hear my dog or something like that. This is amazing. We are making this happen, and everybody's making this happen right from their places. And also the players are playing that from their places. This is amazing. So, but let's go for the first confrontation of the first final of this session. We are going to start with the men's final, Ben. So we have Barbara with her interviews that we're going to watch soon before we start the finals, okay?
Okay.
So let's call Barbara for her interviews with the finalists, the men's finalists.
Hello, everyone. Are you ready to discover who are the best university player in the world? After 11 days of competitions, we have reached the last day of FISU Challenge eSports Football. These were days of great emotion and competitiveness. An unprecedented worldwide event which brought together participants from all over the world. And today we are going to talk to the finalists to find out how are the expectations for the grand finale. In the men's divisions, we have Mazia Mohafazakti from Islamic Azad University of Kazin against Amran Alduli from Modern College of Business and Science. Hello, boys. Welcome to the final.
First of all, hello, everyone. I hope everyone is doing well.
Hello, everyone. Hope you're doing well. I'm so happy I'm here. Thank you for inviting me.
The first thing I want to know is how are you feeling for this last match?
I'm so glad that I reached to the final. I have got a very nice feeling about the match and I hope that I become the champion.
Well, I am enthusiastic about the final and to provide a good level in this game as I did in the previous one. I have a high confidence in myself as I will do my best to win this game.
Esther, I wanna know, how long have you been playing FIFA?
I have been playing FIFA for 2 years as a pro player. Also, I'm an EA verified player and my ranking in the world is 489.
I have started playing FIFA in 2010, but that was only offline. I have started playing online in 2018 and started playing Ultimate Team and to improve myself to be a professional player.
The third thing I want to know is, have you ever participated in any other university competition or this FISU challenge is the first?
Unfortunately, no. This is the first one for me.
No, I have never participated in any other university competitions, and it's my very first experience in university competitions.
And what do you think of the FISU competitions? How was the experience?
It was very good experience for me, and I hope in the future we don't have the internet connection problems between players. And I want to say thank you to the FISU for holding this competition while coronavirus is epidemic.
A great organization for the tournament, as it includes different players from different nationalities around the world. This is something special about it. A rare experience of its kind, and to access to this role is not easy, as it requires working hard and self-confidence, as it is important to maintain the level and gearing for the future.
And finally, that I know you must be anxious to the game, I would like to leave a message for your opponent.
First of all, I wish him good luck, but he should know that I'm not an easy opponent and I'm here to become the champion.
I wish all the best for him and good luck, as I hope to enjoy this moment and enjoy the competition.
Once again, thank you for inviting me. I wish you all the best.
Thank you everyone for this moment and see you later on the game.
That was great. That was great. What a nice interview. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, players. Ah, that was really nice to see their faces, right, man?
No, it was good. I mean, I had the opportunity to FaceTime Marseille a few times before the tournament started just to get some information about him. Mm-hmm. And he was there with his brother, because Marseille said Marseille is not very confident of speaking English. Mm-hmm. So Marseille's brother was with him, and but we didn't need much English because we were speaking football. As you saw there, Marseille was wearing his Liverpool top. He's a diehard Liverpool fan. I didn't get the chance of speaking with Amran, though. But Amran, we exchanged messages on Instagram Messenger. So he's a nice guy as well. So, yeah.
That's nice.
Two very nice guys.
Yeah. And one of them will be the best university esports player in the world of football, right? So these faces.
At the end of this, in the next 20, 25 minutes, one of them is going to be crowned a world champion. How many people in the world, Paulo, can say they are a world champion? Best in the world, number one.
I'm not a world champion in anything. You know, they must be proud of that. They must be really proud of that.
No, they should take it. Yeah. And run with it for the rest of their life, and put it on their TV for the rest of their life is in size font 48.
Yeah, that's gonna be amazing. So FISU, the entire organizing committee, and we wish you guys the best of luck, and let's see some action, man. The first final of the day.
Let's go. Amran Adali taking on the very, very talented Masih Mohafazatka, should I say. And don't forget Masih in the Liverpool top. Yeah, he was wearing the Liverpool top in the interview. And he's also wearing his Liverpool top right now with the players on the screen. And in the yellow top and the red arrow is Amran Adali. Don't forget Amran Adali. You know what? He was the dark horse of his group, second in Group F. He won two, lost one. Whereas Marseille has just been cruising the whole tournament. But he was given a good run for his money by Natawit from Thailand. They had to go to the third and final game for a golden goal. So,
Yeah.
So Marseille was given a huge scare in the semi-final. But that's the way it rolls. So here's Marseille. He's got the ball. He's advancing. I lost the ball right there. And you know what, Paulo? With Amran, you can never be relaxed because you don't know when he can come alive and just get some goals.
Yeah. But that's not going to be an easy match for both sides, right? You know, I don't know why, but I'm expecting a third match for this confrontation as well.
Seriously. Are you?
Yeah. I don't know why, but I'm expecting something like that.
Well, we didn't expect Natawit
Hong Kit
Pat from Rangsit University, Thailand, to be so dangerous in the semi. He has the goal saved there by Marseille's keeper. And now Marseille on the counter attack. But this is good defending by Amran to get the ball back.
Again.
Could this be the first goal? Deflection. Ooh, saved by the keeper. Amran looking dangerous, I must admit. And he's using a tactic here to press. I mean, electronically, that is, to press Marseille's players, to be in their face, to shut them down, close them down.
Yeah.
So that's a very good tactic.
So I would like to thank everybody who are watching us right now from Twitch. Thank you guys for coming. There's a bottle right below the screen. You can follow us here on Twitch. And also, if you scroll down a little bit more, please interrupt me if I'm being too long. So you can find our social media link. So please follow us to know more about the whole world of university esports around the world from our social media, our FISU social media.
That's right. And Marseille needs this just to improve in possession. Because Amran, at the moment, I must say, Paulo, Amran is the better player at the moment in terms of tactics and technique.
Yeah, yeah.
He's holding onto the ball better. He's pressing better. He's making some big tackles.
Yeah, he's leading the possession of the ball.
And this is where, in the semi-final, Natawit from Thailand really took us, well, he took us by surprise, but a nice surprise, that is.
Yeah.
Marseille with the tackle there from the back, countering, but lost the ball there. He's lost the ball quite a few times in this game.
Yeah.
Amran.
Look at that.
Amran gets the opening goal. Amran Adali. So Rud Hulit.
That was great.
And Dutch national team player, the man with the dreadlocks, 1-0, Amran Adali.
First goal of the finals.
What did I say to you, Paulo? Amran started the better, and that's why he's in front. He deserves to be in front.
Yeah.
So Marseille, he's been here before because he was trailing against Natar. So he's got enough experience. Don't forget, he had an 11-0 win over Happy Ananum in the tournament. That was a record.
We also have a record from Twitch, Ben.
What's the record?
Almost 500 people watching us.
Nice. Hello, everyone. Good morning or good evening, wherever you are around the world. Hope you're enjoying this broadcast on Twitch. Yes. Leave a comment in any language. Sorry, Paulo, did you want to say something?
Nope. Go ahead, Ben, and make your incredible comments about the match.
Well, Amran just in complete control here at the moment. And please leave comments here, everyone. Amran looking for the second goal. Amran, Ooh, almost squeezed it through right there. So everyone, please leave some comments on the Twitch. You can leave it in any language that you wish. So, Masse really needs to get a hold of the ball. This is Amran looking extremely dangerous. And that is the first half at the moment. 1-0.
Yep.
And not surprised that's the score. Could have been more for Amran Adali.
Yeah.
And Mate has not really had a goal scoring opportunity in the first half, Paulo.
Yeah, that, you know, this is why esports and especially football is totally unpredictable. I was not expecting, you know, Adali really leading the match, you know, and Mate, like, you know, trying and not having great opportunities as he had from his previous matches in this challenge, you know. Well, totally different. This is a really hard match for both sides.
Amran, good save by the keeper, but that's a good point there, Paulo, because football these days is not just about playing football.
Yeah.
It's about stopping your opponent. If Jose Mourinho, he's coached Tottenham Hotspurs, used to coach Manchester United and Chelsea, Portuguese guy, very good coach. If he demonstrated anything to the world, it's about stopping your opponent.
Yeah.
Shutting down their best players. And, you know, the whole world is catching on.
Yeah.
So here's Mase. Can he find his first goal-scoring opportunity? Mase needs to hit. Remember, not too many passes. Just hit the thing.
Yeah.
Smash it. Go
hit
for goal.
Hit the ball. Hit the ball, as you like to say. Hit the ball.
Hit it.
He went hit, for it. The pass. Hit it.
Again, he went to for too many passes.
Yeah.
And now, because too many passes, he lost the ball. And Amran is going to counter. This is very, very Jose Mourinho football. Hit you on the counter attack.
And I would like to remember our friend from Twitch. There's a QR code on the corner of the screen and in the bottom side, and then this QR code so goes straight to a link for you to download the FISU TV app. So the best way for you to get notified when FISU is live, not only for esports but everything about sports, university sports around the world, our competitions, world championships, and everything. Please download the app. That's going to be nice.
No, it's going to be, yeah, download it. That's good advice there, Paulo. Oh, this is a bit better here by Mase. Moving the ball better.
Yeah.
Forward. Securing possession.
Ooh.
This is it. Turn, hit.
Yes.
Turn and hit. That's what you got to do. Killing Mbappe. You should be given an award, Killing Mbappe, for how many goals he scored for all the teams.
Yeah. He helped all the teams.
It's 1-1. It is all tied once again. And Mase, Mohafe Zakar was playing much, much better in the second half.
Yeah.
Full credit to him. But Amran Adali never, ever, ever, ever write this man off, because he will just come out of nowhere and score goals. There was one particular match that he was on the back foot for most of it, and then all of a sudden he just scored a couple of crucial goals towards the end to get the win. So,
great. Very
hard to say that you can dominate, but not necessarily you'll win the game. So if this match can stay 1-1, that would be very interesting. There's an easy save by Amran's keeper. I mean, sorry, Marseille's keeper, my mistake. And Marseille taking his time. There's the clearance.
Long ball.
Out. So it's going to be a throw-in for Amran. We're in the 70-minute zone. Oh, almost a cutout there by Marseille.
Yeah.
Marseille's ball. So Marseille is playing like Amran now. Amran in the first half, that is, which was pressing and really moving the ball around.
Yeah. Pitch
quite well. This is Marseille. This is a good opportunity. Should hit it. Oh, that's it. Too much time on the ball once again. Don't forget, everyone, as Paolo has reminded us all tournament long, in the knockout phase, if a match or a tie after two legs is still even score, we will go to a third and decisive match with a golden goal rule. For those of you aware of the golden goal rule, it is if you score in that match, regardless of how much time is left on the clock, you will win the match, which Masih Moha Fezatkar did against Nata of Thailand. Okay, Amran finds the back of the net. He hit Eusebio.
This guy's, you know, this player, Eusebio, he scored a lot of goals for all the teams as well, right?
Well, Eusebio, Ronaldo from Brazil, that is. Kylian Mbappe and Johan Cruyff. Those are the four top scorers for most teams. But Eusebio, Johan Cruyff.
Yeah.
The late Eusebio and Mbappe. The late Johan Cruyff are legends of the sport.
Yeah.
Marseille looking to hit back immediately.
Ooh.
And now Amran has woken up once again.
A little bit dangerous movements.
Playing well again. Trying to stay on the ball. Marseille with a dangerous clearance there. Amran wins it back. Amran. Marseille trying to go build on the counter attack. But Amran's got the more numbers. Good transition, defensive transition by Amran. Marseille advancing, pushing forward, needs to get a pass, needs to go for a hit. Oh, he should have gone for goal.
Yeah.
And I think this match was finished at 2-1 in favor of Amran Adali of Modern College of Business and Science in Oman.
Yeah, man, 2-1 to Adali. That means one goal ahead for him. So in the aggregate, we have 2-1. So the next match, we need the next match to see if we don't see any goals difference after this second match. Then we will need a third match with a golden goal, as you said, right, Ben?
Yeah, that's right. So it's 2-1. It's only half time.
Yeah.
If Marseille scores another goal in the second match, it's balanced once again. So it's tight. I don't read anything too much into it, but I am nicely surprised that Amran is really taking this game to the favorite Marseille, Moha Fezatkar, and he's playing it by playing very, very technical, disciplined, defensive football.
Yeah.
So
you know, my prediction about this second match is everything can happen.
Yeah, everything can happen.
Everything. So, Ben, let's go for the second match of this great final for the men's.
Let's go and have a look. This is exciting stuff, everybody.
Yeah.
We could be crowning a champion in the next 15 minutes.
Yep.
So Masi in the white arrow, and Amran Adali with the red arrow. So let's see what's going on right here.
Ben, could you remember our friends from Twitch who's gonna play at the finals, at a final for the girls next to this match?
It's gonna be the one and only Naj Fahad against Alexandra from Brazil.
Yep.
You know, Alexandra has had a very good, both have had great tournaments.
Yeah.
So, yeah, both were in the same group.
Group B. Yeah.
In the, so.
From the same group, and then they ended up in a final.
That's right.
Pretty nice. Stay tuned, guys. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned. It's still a stalemate here.
Yeah.
But I suppose both players are a bit nervous now. That's what the final does to you all the time. You're always a bit nervous.
Yeah. I'm a little bit nervous as well. That's not every day you present an international international challenge live to people from all over the world, right, Ben?
That's right, that's right. I mean, I say that all the time.
Whoa! What a great shot, Ben! Look at that! We'll have the first goal for this second match of the final.
Well, just as we were talking about everything, what a hit right there. Rocketed.
That was great from Masse.
Exploded it into the back of the net, and Masse has tied this up.
Yeah. 2-2 right now in the aggregate.
So it's even. We are even.
Definitely.
Who can Masse get another goal, or can Amran get another goal to push back in front?
Yeah.
Masse take the lead for the very first time in this tie. It is such. It's a little bit scrappy. Gotta close him down. Ooh, almost
close.
Third goal there for Amran Adali. Masse living a bit dangerously. He's giving the ball away a lot. A bit too frequently compared to his usual self. And that's dangerous. Amran playing free-flowing football. Gotta be shut down. Amran, ooh. Good pressure by Masse, but Amran looking dangerous. Look, Amran gets the ball back. Amran, this is a goal-scoring opportunity. Amran. You know what, Paulo? Amran has just knocked on the door of scoring goals.
Yeah.
Three times in the last 45.
Really, really promising opportunities. Yeah.
Pull away again. This match, if it stays the way it is, we are going to a golden goal game.
Yeah. That would be exciting.
That would be cool, actually.
You know, to decide a final with only one goal.
Yeah. You know what? Doesn't matter how you played before. If you didn't rock up that game and score the goal and stop the goal.
Yeah, that looks like penalties.
Amran with the majority of possession in this match. Masse must be frustrated at the moment. Gotta clear. Just clear it. That's it. Now on the counter attack. But good transition by Amran. In terms of defensive, this is better by Masse. Good numbers by Amran. That's why Masse is passing the ball backwards. He needs to go forward. He needs to be a little bit more positive. Good turn. Great pass. Tries to squeeze it through. Couldn't find a way through. Ooh. Dangerous clearance there by the keeper of Amran. Amran Adali. Another goal would give him back the advantage in this tie. Masse. Good cut out there by Masse. This is a bit better by Masse, but the numbers, defensive numbers of Amran causing Masse a bit of headache, some headaches at the moment. Who's going to be the champion? Okay, Masse. Masse goes backwards. Trying to drive at Amran's defense. This is good. Should have gone for the hit. Oh, he lost. I think Masse makes that mistake again. Half time approaching in the second match here. And it looks like it's going to be Masse in front, 1-0. And the tie is all squared at 2-2. And that's half time, everyone.
Yeah. Half time.
Even though Amran is trailing,
nothing Amran is defined.
He's looking more dangerous. I'm going to say that. He's looking extremely dangerous. And Masse needs to change his tactics in the second half if he wants to get another goal. So we're about to resume. So stay with us. Thank you for being with us. We really, really appreciate it.
Yeah.
And to all our contestants or players who have reached out to me, and we're now following each other on social media. Inshallah, as we say in Malaysia, the friendship will be forever. You know, hopefully we'll get to work together again in more tournaments. The sporting world is a small world.
Yeah.
And we can say we became friends through FISU.
Yeah. We became friends, right, Ben? Yeah, you and me here.
I'm not going to miss you at 4 o'clock in the morning, I'll be honest.
Only at the first session of the day, not the second one. Four in the morning for you.
Yeah. If you call me at 4 o'clock in the morning after today, I may not pick up. If you call me at 4 o'clock in the morning in the last 10 days, yeah, I definitely would pick up.
Yeah.
So Amran with the ball now, looking for that equalizer, gave the ball away. Here comes Masse, the urban engineering student. The man who loves Liverpool.
Yeah.
He's a diehard, staunch Liverpool supporter. You never walk alone. A good football club, Liverpool.
Yeah.
And surprising that he's a Liverpool supporter, because, you know what? I mean, in English Premier League football, Manchester United have tasted so much success that almost every second fan I met over the last 10 years is be a goal. Oh, good tackle. Yeah. Goal-saving tackle by Amran Adali. And because of that tackle, counter-attack. Got the ball. Yes, the girls' final, like you said, Paolo, should be very, very exciting.
Very exciting. I'm so excited to watch their matches.
Naj Fahad has only lost one match in this whole tournament.
Yeah.
Masse looking to build here. The next goal will be crucial for Both players. Massey, he's got to hit it now. No, he's got... Okay, that's a good effort. He turned and he hit. He had three players. Neymar, who Massey was controlling, had three players trying to close him down. So he had no choice but to go for the strike. So that was good stuff. Amran trying to find a way through. If Amran scores the first goal of this match or this game, he will lead the tie. And he will have a huge advantage because we're down the home stretch for this second match. Amran.
Ben, do you believe there's like only 20 minutes to go to finish this second match, and we are really close to the third match?
I think we will go to a third match with the way things are going, because both players are struggling to find a way through.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's not because of their skill or whatever. It's because of nerves.
Yeah, I think so.
Fancy football goes out the back door. In a final, you just want to win the game. Massé with the ball, dancing.
Yeah.
Okay, oh, just couldn't find a way, couldn't squeeze it through right there.
They're not taking risks, right? Like to shot out of the box, something like that.
Very conservative.
Yeah.
Spring surveying. Trying to find out what's going on in terms of options.
You know, they're defending way more than they are attacking.
Yes, yes, this is very... The Italians will be very proud. Okay. Oh, good save by Massey's keeper. That could have been...
That could be a golden goal, right, man?
That could have been the match.
Yeah.
Okay, but this could be the match. Massey, he's in the box, well, almost in the box. He wants to move it around.
Oh, lose the ball.
Hey.
Lost the ball. So if you're watching us right now from Twitch, listen to me. Take a picture, post in your Instagram, and tag FISU so we know you are here with us. And if you also want to use our great hashtag for this challenge, Unigaming. So please do that. Tag us.
That's right. Put it on your Instagram, put it on your Facebook, put it on Twitter.
Yeah.
Tag us, FISU, all the way. I think we're going to golden goal.
Definitely, man.
But really? Wants to get... Oh, okay. He's got a chance here. No goal.
One last try.
Massey crosses. He's got to turn and hit. Just turn and hit it.
Strike it. Look at that. Seriously. Great opportunity at the end. But nothing happened, man. Nothing.
No. 2-1. Yeah. 1-0.
So, according to the rules of the challenge, let's go for the third match of this. Oh, yeah. We still have. That's not done yet.
Done.
Still have a quarter.
Okay, got carried away there. Sorry about that. Oh! That could have been the championship.
Yeah.
Turns. And yes, we will That's finally go pro.
Yeah. Do you have some words for this moment, Ben? No, because I'm running out of words.
Couldn't have scripted any better final than what it is right now.
Yeah.
2-1, 1-0. That could have been the decider right there, but he missed. It is going to be a golden goal. So there is no, like, I should have, I could have, I would have. There is no coming back from a golden goal. You score the goal, you win the game.
Yeah. And this is the goal for the first place of this challenge. So the words I have right now is, let's go for the third match.
Let's go, let's go. Good luck to both players.
Good luck. We wish you the best of luck.
The golden goal.
Please receive these wishes from everybody, from the chat, universities, FISU, entire organizing committee. We are here with us, with you.
And Amran with the ball right now. Both players are going to be super, super nervous.
Yeah. So, Ben, let me just use it this moment before we see the first place and the second place. Please follow us on Twitch. There's a button with a heart below the screen. Click on that, then you're going to follow us here on Twitch. That's going to be amazing.
I'll see.
Thanks for supporting us. This is the best way for you to support and show your support for this challenge, following us.
Masse spinning, turning, losing the ball. Here comes Amran. Okay, can he get out of his own half? Backwards. Looks like Amran Adali wants to starve Masih Muhafizatkar of any form of possession or touching the football. A good tactic to use.
Yep.
A very, very good tactic. Will we see this kind of drama in the girls' match? Amran. Cut out there by Masih.
You know, the way they're playing this final, we can stay here waiting for this goal to the end of the match.
All that sticky tipping, tapping.
Yeah, and all like, nobody's hitting the ball.
Oh, that's football, though.
Yeah.
That's the way she works.
A lot of pressure. Over their shoulders.
And I think the whole eSports community will go absolutely ballistic and mad in a good way, in a positive way, if Alessandra Bacista won the final. She has a lot of supporters.
Yeah. I'm expecting a lot of friends from Twitch to watch and support her here. Both, actually.
Well,
because they both have
engaging
fans.
Very engaging fans.
Ben.
That's the goal.
That's a goal.
Eusebio.
Adali.
Goal. Champion. Campione.
First place. Adali. Congratulations.
What a smasher of a goal.
That was great.
He's just back to us immediately.
Yeah, you know, I was like shocked. That was incredible.
Well done, Amran Adali.
Yeah.
He was the dark horse of the game for the match. But he played well. He played
Really well.
very well. And in that third game,
Yeah.
super, super tactical.
Yeah. That was, great, great. Congratulations, all you guys, Abdali, Massey, the third place, all you guys are part of the history. Thank you so much for that. That was amazing. And Adali is now, the
Campeón.
first place. Yeah, he is. The best university player of eSports football in the world. Congratulations, Adali. You can, right now this title is yours. You can start, telling that to your friends and everybody that you are the best university player of eSports in the world, eSports football. So, we have another final for today, right, Ben?
Can't get emotional right now. We
Yeah.
have to move on because
Yeah.
we have two very, very talented esports players, Naj
Yeah.
Fahad versus Alessandra Bachista.
Batista. Yeah, that's it. So Ben, before we start the girls final, we have another interview with
Let's
these
have a look.
incredible players. Let's call Barbara, and she has a great interview with them.
Hello, ladies, welcome to the final.
Oi, Bárbara. E aí, galera, tudo tranquilo? Queria mandar um salve aí pra galera que tá me acompanhando e tá torcendo. A torcida aí da Lelequita, tamo junto sempre.
Hi.
The first thing I wanna know is how are you feeling for this last match?
Eu tô bem ansiosa. Sei que vai ser uma partida difícil, a gente já se enfrentou, né, na primeira rodada da chave de grupos. E eu tô bem ansiosa pra isso.
مباراة صعبة أولا لأنها نهائي وثانيا لأني قابلت الخصم في دور المجموعات وأعرف إمكانيات الخصم جيدا، ولكني أتمنى أنها تكون مباراة ممتعة لي وللخصم وللمشاهدين.
And how long have you been playing FIFA?
Bem, o FIFA mesmo eu comecei a jogar o ano passado, né, no Campeonato Universitário Cearense e acabei conquistando a vaga para o Campeonato Brasileiro.
لعبت فيفا في 2008 تقريبا لي 12 سنة ألعبها.
I want to know too if have you ever participated in any other university competition or the FISU challenge is the first?
Sim, já participei de outras competições universitárias. Eu sou atleta de futebol, né? E o ano passado eu disputei os Jogos Universitários Brasileiros pela modalidade de futebol de 7, futebol, e o JUBES fase final de esportes FIFA.
لا هذه أول تجربة لي وسعيدة إني أعطيت الفرصة.
And what do you think of the physical competition? How was the experience?
Foi uma competição que eu não esperava, é um campeonato mundial, né? E tá vivendo isso é incrível. Eu tô muito feliz. É uma competição que eu espero que continue, né? E que traga visibilidade para o esporte, que é uma modalidade incrível.
تجربة ممتعة، بطولة رائعة، اجتمع فيها أفضل اللاعبين على مستوى الجامعات في العالم، تنظيم رائع، ورغم هذه الظروف إلا أنها بطولة ناجحة جدا.
And finally, that I know you must be anxious to the game too, like the males, I would like to leave a message for your opponent.
A Najad é uma atleta incrível e eu desejo boa sorte para ela e que seja uma ótima partida e que vença o melhor.
أتمنى لها التوفيق ووصولنا إلى المرحلة النهائية بحد ذاتها إنجاز، إن فازت فأنا سعيدة لها وإن خسرت حظ أوفر لها في بطولات أخرى.
So that's it, guys. I want to thank you, all the guests, for participating in their interview and good luck on the matches. Thank you too for watching us and all this day. Stay now with the FISU Challenge eSports Final and let's see who are the best university player in the world.
Thank you, girls. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, Nadj. And thank you, Alexandra. Thank you for this incredible interview. That was really nice to see their faces as well, man. Right?
Great. Great, because these were two players I didn't get an opportunity to talk to during the tournament. I mean, we exchanged voice notes on WhatsApp, but we didn't get a chance to talk and have a bit of a discussion and find out about their background. But it was always nice to see a name or face. That's what sports is all about. I mean, eSports, we don't see the faces, we don't see the emotion, but it was good to see the faces and the emotion right there of both the players. And it was a good interview by Barbara. So it was good information that they shared with us. Well done.
Yeah, especially because, you know, in this challenge, eSports, you can see their reactions during the matches, you know, and seeing them right now, you know, talking and being interviewed by Barbara. That was really, really nice. And, you know, I wish I had a great gaming chair like Nadj's chair. That was really nice to see. So any briefing overview about this final and any expectations, predictions? That's, you know, that's the last chance for you to make a prediction. Are you going to make a prediction or not, Ben?
Oh, he's going to try to lure me out to make a prediction. I'm not making a prediction.
Yeah.
I don't think it will go to, the only prediction I'm making is that I don't think it'll go to a third and final golden goal match. I think it'll be two legs, and it'll be settled then, and Nadj Farhad is the favorite, but never, ever underestimate Brazilian, and never write a Brazilian off in football.
Of course, Ben. Well said, well said. Thank you so much, guys, for being here with us, especially you guys from Twitch. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that. That's going to be really exciting. The second final of the day. But at this time, the women's final. And that's going to be really, really nice. So, FISU and the entire organizing committee wish you all, you know, the best of luck. Thank you so much for that. Thank you so much for being part of this historical time with us. Let's see some action, right, Ben? Let's start this girls' final.
Let's go. It is the women's final.
Yeah.
Alexandra Batista of Uni Ateneo of Brazil versus Nadj Farhad of Saud Islamic University in Riyadh in Saudi Arabia. She will start as the favorite, the winner of her group. Nadj Farhad, 1-4, lost 1, versus Alexandra, who was third in her group, in Group B, the same group. She won 3 and lost 1. So, all to play for right here. Early days yet. Alexandra in the white arrow, Nadj in the red arrow. So from the back, Nadj, can she live up to her favorite tag? Oh, Nadj, looking dangerous from the wing. Couldn't find that pass into the last third. Alexandra. Nadj gets the ball back. Nadj. Backwards, forwards. Trying to find a way through. Making her opponent move. That's it. This is a good opportunity here. Ooh, good tackle by Alexandra.
Yeah. Gray.
Alexandra. She hasn't looked threatening yet, but it can all change in a blink of an eye. Alexandra. Ooh. Alexandra. Oh, keeper. Want it right there.
So hello everyone from Twitch, Alexandra and Nads supporters. Thank you so much for coming. Please follow us here on Twitch. Click on the heart button. So then you're going to follow us here. That's going to be a pleasure having you guys here with us.
That's right. Now, Nudge. Looking dangerous. Nudge, this could be the goal. Nudge. Oh, save there. Oh, save, but the rebound. Well done. Nudge Fahad pushes in front. And this is not unexpected. Ronaldo scores the opening goal for Nudge Fahad. The keeper saved it. Alexandra's keeper saved it, but then got the rebound, pushed it through, pushed it past the keeper. And it is Nudge Fahad who leads this morning, tonight, 1-0. Good build-up play by Nudge, but can Alexandra hit back? The pride of South America.
Yeah.
From the midfield right now.
Quite early goal for this second final.
You know what, Paulo? That's a good point, but I'll take a goal. You just need one goal to light it up. The first goal is crucial.
Yeah. In a challenge like this, you only need one goal.
That's right.
To be crowned the champion.
Nudge Fahad wants to be that champion.
Yeah.
She's got the ball. Can she find the second? Ooh, good block by Alexandra, but Nudge gets the ball back. Nudge dominating possession, Paulo.
Yeah.
And at the moment, Alexandra has not found... She hasn't looked very threatening. But it could change. Turns. Nudge. Trying to squeeze it through. Turns. Trying to beat almost, she's doing a good job here. Another goal almost through Neymar. Hey, Paulo, I just want to ask you, who's the biggest footballer in Brazil at the moment? Is it Neymar? Is it Charleston?
Right now, it's being Neymar. You know, I'm not a big football fan. I might be wrong, but, you know, yeah, our most famous football player at this time is Neymar.
You know what? If you want to find out the most famous football player in your country, don't ask a football fan. You know? So, if non-football fans, oh, yeah, Neymar, you know? So, yeah, okay. That's the first name that comes to your head. So, it's not about these two players right now. If one of them gets the win, one of them will be really famous. Amran Adali is the champion of the FISU eSports Challenge 2020 male competition. Congratulations to Amran. He was the better player in the final. He won on an aggregate score of 3-2. Golden goal. What a smasher of a goal. And, ooh, good save, good strike, good save. And it's corner.
That is really nice to see the Brazilian flags.
And it's an opportunity to go for another goal. But the keeper is on it. halftime very, very soon in this first match. What time is it in Brazil at the moment, Paulo?
Right now is 6. Oh!
Oh! 6. But that's the second. We're talking six. About the time. And then Ronaldo from Brazil.
Yeah, 6 is not the number, the amount of goals at this time. It's just the time here in Brazil.
What a strike by Ronaldo.
Yeah.
The controller. Nudge Fahad, 2-0. She is comfortably in front. What a time to score before halftime. A huge psychological advantage for the talented player, esports player from Saudi Arabia. And Alexandra needs to step up her game right here in the second half. She's still got a lot of time to do it. She's got the second half and she's got the whole of the next match. So don't think that this match is a foregone conclusion. It is not. So we want an exciting, unpredictable game, Paulo.
Really, really unpredictable. Yeah, right now, Naj is leading the scoreboard for this final. 2 goals ahead. But there is another match after this one. So everything can happen.
Indeed it can. Naj Fahad. Alexandra Batista, the student of architecture and urbanization. Oh, could have been the leveler right there. And you know what? She has done a great job, Naj Fahad, with controlling the goalkeeper. And she's in right here for another goal scoring opportunity, but lost the ball. Wins the ball back. Good press. Good pass. Oh, hits the bar. Could have been a third goal for Naj Fahad. Alexandra. Thank you, lucky stars. Kiss that post 10 times, as I say. That could have been the third goal. And now...
Yeah, that really could be a third goal.
Naj Fahad pulling all the strings, but Alexandra, if she can get one goal, she's... Oh my God, Naj is playing so well from the back. Defensively, good transition here. Counter attack. Needs to pass. Good pass. One of the strikers needs to go for a good. Started going for a run now.
And ow. That
should be a goal kick. Goal kick right here. Naj with majority of possession in this match. Naj building up here, looking, threading. This is a goal! Goal! Ronaldo with a hat trick.
Yeah. With that legendary haircut from the World Cup.
Actually, I'm watching a documentary at the moment on Bobby Robson. The late Bobby Robson, who coached Barcelona, where Ronaldo was the dominating factor in the 90s. And Ronaldo, you should see him now. He's very different to what how he is when he was playing. But still, he seems like a very, very nice guy. His English is very good. Okay, this looks good. Oh, good defending by Naj. I keep saying this, Paulo, but Naj has defended so well in this match. And you know what? I think if Naj wins, she has something in common with Amran in terms of Amran Adali, the winner of the men's competition. They both defended extremely well in the final.
And yeah.
It's offside.
This is really, really nice to see.
Three nil, Najfahad leads right now. There's some statistics for you, everyone. So stay with us. And stay in touch, everybody. Stay in touch. Because we want to be talking about this tournament for a good long time to come. For me, it has been nothing short of spectacular. I've never commentated from home, to be honest, in my living room.
Ben. Okay.
Goal.
Whoa.
Goal, 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 goal. Magnificent. Ronaldo on four goals in this game. But
four
Ronaldo
goals.
Take the credit. It is all Najfahad, who is in cruise control right now. 4-0
yeah.
In the 74th minute. This is going to be a huge, monumental task for Alexandra Batista.
You know, you can use... You can use the same adjectives for Nards win. You know, that is a monumental win for this challenge. Really nice. You know, but you're talking about statistics. Let me give you a number. We have more than 800 friends right now from Twitch.
800? No way.
More than 800. Thank you so much, guys, for coming. Please don't forget to follow us on Twitch.
Okay, I'm going to have a look at Twitch right now. Sorry, I've got Twitch on my phone.
Yeah.
So I'm not really looking at my phone. I'm looking more at my laptop where to dictate the action.
Yeah.
So... But it's great to hear, Paulo. Thanks for sharing that. And a big shout out to my good friend, Paulo Salvador, who's done a fantastic job in this tournament. A great co-host.
Ooh. It's the war.
She can't get a goal at the moment.
Yeah.
Sandra. Okay. Another one. This could be another one. Smashing goal right there.
Another one.
And as we talk about Neymar, he comes on the score sheet. The most famous player in Brazil, in your land of Brazil, Paulo.
Yeah.
Finds the back of the net.
Nad supporters must be really proud of her right now.
Oh, they will be ecstatic.
Yo, I would like to ask Nad supporters to take a screenshot, a picture, everything you want, you know, anything you want from this screen. Please post in your Instagram and tag FISU so we can know you are here supporting your player, Naj, the queen of the jungle.
I knew you'd say that.
Yeah, I was waiting for the right moment to say that.
You know, that. You should put a commercial together, Paulo. The yeah. Queen of the Jungle, Najfahad.
Yeah.
By Paulo Salvador.
And from Ben the Commentator, what is your phrase? Good save by the keeper, Ben the Commentator.
I'm glad you were listening.
You know, I wake up in the morning every day with this phrase in my head.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Share that. Out of all the things I said, that is the one. Okay, this could be no save required. But this will be a save required. Oh, hits the bar.
Yeah. What?
Big ones.
Okay, go ahead, Ben.
Big ones.
Out of words.
And I don't want to be disrespectful to Alexandra, but it's going to be super, super hard in the second match. Let's be honest.
Now, being completely honest, that's going to be really hard for her. Yeah, but she's a fighter. Definitely. All of the players are fighters. They're going to go, she's going to go and, fight for this final, but that's going to be really hard, indeed.
Well, you know what? If she made the comeback of all comebacks, I'm not going to complain whatsoever.
Yeah.
So, can she? Will she? We'll find out soon.
Yeah, that's going to be, I can't wait. I can't wait to watch the second match. Let's see the action, Ben. Let's see the action.
Let's stop talking and let's get
to it. Yeah. We have more than... Well, look at that, man. We have almost 1,000 people watching us.
Thank you, everyone, for being with us.
Thank you. That's great.
Good luck to both players, Naj Fahad and Alexandra Batista.
Thank you all for coming. Please bring your friends. Let's go over 1,000 people watching this incredible girls at this final.
That's right. No, 5-0 at the moment. Naj Fahad leads in this tie. If Alexandra can just score one goal, then there's a fighting chance she could make a good meal out of this second match. But at the moment, Naj Fahad with the ball, but just gone. Sorry, Naj Fahad won the ball back, should I say. And Naj Fahad looking friendly once again. So, good defending there by Alexandra. Thank you, terima kasih. Obrigado to all our merci beaucoup, gracias. Those are the languages that I can say thank you. Thank you so much for being with us. Oh, Naj squares it.
Puts
it past the keeper for the sixth goal right here. The first goal of the second match. The sixth goal of the tie. Naj Fahad, it is time to say six. Not 6 o'clock. It is six goals today. And Kylian Mbappe, they should call the leading goal scorer, the Golden Boot Award should go to Kylian Mbappe. How many goals did he score? 100 goals in this tournament? So 6-0, as we were saying, Alexandra just needed to find a way through to get her a goal. But it's not going to come now.
Look at that, Ben.
This could be seven.
Seven. Here we go.
Ronaldo cannot stop scoring, but...
Yeah.
Ronaldo cannot take the credit. It is Naj Fahad. She is on another planet right now.
She is under his control.
So, good job.
Out of the net. Good job, Naj. You rock. Definitely.
My turn to say it. And here's Alexandra. Alexandra just trying to get one goal to finish strong.
Yeah.
Good shot, but a great save there by Jens Lehmann, who's the keeper of Nudge.
7 goals in the aggregate.
It could be 8.
Whoa!
Right there.
He's
by Nudge.
Playing.
Just flicked it over.
Yeah.
To move forward, to advance. That's... Cut out. Nudge. From the wing, from the flank. Advancing. Good cut, pull back right there. Good save by Alexandra. That's a good moment right there for her. That's a goal.
Yeah.
That's a goal stopping... Save
she
right there,
wants but more. She wants more.
Nudge tries to chip the keeper. Header. Ball bouncing everywhere like a hot potato. Nudge turns. She's in. Oh, good tackle there by Alexandra. Very, very good tackle. And there's about... How many minutes left in this match? Still got about over 50 minutes. Alexandra wouldn't get away through. Here's Nudge from the wing, long ball. She'll keep it in play. Well done, Nudge. All right, this looks good right here. Go for the shot. Nope. She's got nothing to lose at the moment. She's up 8-0, 6-0 from the first leg, 2-0 in the second leg.
Yeah.
She's playing free-flowing football right now. It's great to see, but she's making a few mistakes here and there in terms of losing possession, but doesn't really matter. She's in complete control.
And she has a huge advantage.
Alexandra Bautista has to score 9 goals and not concede 1 to win this. She's had a few shots on target though in this match.
Yeah.
Alexandra Bautista from Uni Ateneo. Corner. Punch out by the keeper.
Almost half time for this second match.
Yes, it is. No rest right here for anybody, for these two players. They just have to get on with it and move with it. Here comes Nudge. She's a goal scoring machine. She will be a great player. Looking for the third goal of this match. Couldn't get a shot. Couldn't get the shot. Couldn't connect. Nudge building from the back once again. And at the start of the tournament, it was Faria Mo'arafi from Islamic Azad University of Iran, who was the favorite. And it is 2-0 right here. There's the stats, everyone. Nudge, surprisingly, only with 52% possession. 52% possession. And Alexandra with 48%. So, but statistics are statistics. At the end of the day, it's all about who's in front. That's the only stat that you want. Here we go. The match will resume. The second half. And it looks very, very strong. That Nudge Fahad leading 6-0 will lift the trophy. She will be the female champion of this tournament.
Yeah, we are really close to see officially the champion of the girls from the FISU eSports Challenge.
That's right.
The second title of this day. That's going to be really, really nice.
Naj Fahad from Saud Islamic University in Riyadh in the United Arab Emirates. A really good university. It's great to see. Okay, she's got... Ooh, that could have been the third goal of the game for Naj. And she is just a few minutes away, Paolo, from being crowned a world champion, a FISU Esports Challenge 2020 world champion. Congratulations to her, but she can't celebrate just yet. Naj is from Riyadh, the nation's capital of Saudi Arabia. To all of Naj's fans, we say hello. We say assalamu alaikum. Naj, oh, threatening. Oh, good cut out there by Batista.
Yeah, let me just remember you guys.
Ooh, what a save, Sandra. That is a very, very good save. She's made some cracking saves in this match.
Yeah, definitely. That was really, really nice.
Was the ball total domination here? Naj. Another good save, Paolo, by Alexander, keeper. Thank you, everyone, again, Naj. What a goal! That was top drawer!
That was great. I can't believe.
A goal. Can we see that again? No, we can't, but it was so good.
Yeah.
Smashed
really, really
it.
Good.
Top drawer. Oh, that was great. 3-0, what a goal. A goal that will drop your jaw, not just right now, but in years to come. Antoine Griezmann getting a yellow card right there. That's something that we don't see very often, that the referee is dishing out cards. This is a very, very good angle right here for the free kick. 67th minute in the box, tries to turn, gets the ball back. Turn, it's got time and space. Got a hit. Oh, good save. Went for a very similar goal. It's compared to the previous goal, the third goal, but it was a good save by Alexandra's goalkeeper. I know the scoreboard is not reflective right now, but if Alexandra did not make a lot of saves in this match, it could be also 6-0 right here. So well done to Alexandra. I know that's not a stat that you want to lead in terms of goalkeeping saves, but take that as a win. That department.
Yeah, we are almost at the end. We had our first winner, finalist from the men's, Abdali. And we are about to know the second winner of this great final day. Thank you so much, guys, for coming. You all from Twitch, our friends from Twitch. I really like to call them our friends.
No, it's good. That's a very, very good way to put it. So we're approaching the 80th minute mark.
Yeah.
And we've crowned one champion tonight. We're about to crown another. And you know what, Paolo?
What?
Hold on, I'm gonna stop talking. No, I'm not. I thought Nacho's gonna score another goal here. Is she gonna score another goal? No. Good save. Both our champions will come from Asia. You know that?
Yeah.
Amran Adali from Oman and Naj Fahad from Saudi Arabia.
Yeah.
So, must say something about esports in the Asia Pacific region. So, maybe popularity increasing. Naj Fahad looking for the fourth goal. If she gets the fourth goal, she will win this tie 10-0.
Can you
believe that? Who wins a final 10-0?
Especially in an incredible challenge like FISU eSports Challenge. Oh, that could be another one.
Naj does not want to stop scoring. She wants to keep going. She's a machine, queen of the jungle.
Yeah.
Who dominate the Amazon.
Whoa. Running out of time.
That's right. But it's over. Start.
Definitely, Ben. 5 minutes to go.
The trophy. Bring out the nice food to celebrate after this. I hope Naj Fahad has some very, very yummy treats for her and her friends to celebrate after this one. Congratulations, Naj.
Yeah.
You have been the most outstanding player in this tournament.
Definitely.
Not one, but it doesn't matter. You top your group B, and then you never looked in any doubt of winning all your matches.
You know, I'm so proud of these girls because they are amazing playing that.
Agreed. Well contestants.
Seriously.
Well contestants in the female category, 32 in the male category. And even though there was more male competitors than female, it was just as hard to win. You know, the quality was very, very good, I must admit. Mahasif Albreki from Zayed University. And then you had Nur Fatiha Abdul Rahman from Malaysia. That is it.
That's it. Congratulations, Naj. Congratulations. The title is yours. You're the champion. And you earn the right to say you are the best university player of esports football in the world. You know, this is amazing. I can't, that was, I would love to see your face right now after this incredible final. Thank you so much for that. How was that, Ben, in your perspective?
No, it was fantastic.
Fantastic.
I'm a little bit disappointed, to be honest, that I wish it was closer. I was hoping for a close game like the men's final. But, you know, you can't predict these things. You can just hope for these things. And if it happens that way, it happens that way. But it didn't happen that way. But, you know, take nothing away. And I want to use this opportunity to congratulate Alexandra Batista for making the final not easy. And she played her heart out. One thing that we probably won't remember is the amount of saves that she made with her goalkeeper. So she did very, very well there. Could have been a bigger scoreline. So well done to her. Well done to Enriquez Gomes for winning the bronze medal in the male category. and to Marcy Mohafizatkar, I will never forget how to say that name.
Yeah, yeah.
Dominating force, winning, you know, 10-0 some matches, 8-2. But, you know, at the end, it's not about dominating throughout the tournament. It's about getting the it's about making the final and winning the final. So yeah, it's good for him. He's got a bright future in front of him. All the players of this tournament in the female category and the male category, they have bright futures, not just in esports, but also with their academic degrees and their professional careers as well. So we wish them all the best. Thank you so much for being with us. You have been nothing but friendly, and we look forward to continuing the friendship for as long as life will take us.
That was amazing. Well said, Ben. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And so we are at the end of this FISU eSports Challenge, and I would love to say that in the name of FISU, we all from the organizing committee, we all from, you know, working in the background to make this challenge happen, we would like to thank all of you guys, all the players, universities, and all of our friends from all the platforms we have been on for this day. So let me just remember you guys. We started 11 days ago, you know, starting from that draw, the first draw of this challenge. We, you know, 11 days ago, we had 37 universities. This is incredible. 37 universities around the world and 32 male participants and 12 female participants. That was huge. That was amazing. A really historical challenge in the FISU's history, the first one. And you all are part of this historical moment. You know, Ben, I'm so, you know, I have to say that all the time because I'm feeling so honored to be here, you know, to be presenting this incredible challenge to you and being here sharing this live streaming screen with you, Ben. That was a great pleasure. I can't wait for the next opportunity to present anything with you for FISU and everything. That was an incredible experience. Thank you so much for that.
No, it's a pleasure, Paolo. I mean, you did very well. And your friendship and your humor was absolutely fantastic. Your professionalism.
Yeah.
You did very, very well as a presenter. And it's not, I mean, take it from me as someone who's been commentating for about 15 years. It's not easy to build chemistry with someone.
Yeah.
You know, you just don't go to the kitchen and get chemistry or make chemistry. You cannot buy it in the supermarket. It's either you have it with someone or you don't. So I have it with you already. And I was just telling my daughter, Kyla, this morning. She was saying, oh, Dada, who's that man with the glasses? I said, that's my friend.
Yeah, I knew we would become friends after this challenge.
If you come to Malaysia and you need a place to stay, something to eat, just knock on my door, send me a WhatsApp and I'll pick you up and... We'll catch
definitely. You will have the same welcome here in Brazil. Thank you so much for that, Ben. So, yeah, thank you all our friends from Twitch. Let's see the screen with all the champions. The first place, second place for both men and women of this FISU eSports Challenge. For the girls, Ben.
Yes, for the girls, it is Naj Fahad, number one. Alexandra Batista, number two. And also there, you got Albrecki.
Yeah.
Salim Albrecki, who defeated Jessica Au for the bronze medal. Jessica Au from Monash University, Australia. So that's the podium right there. First place goes to Naj Fahad, the one and only. She is the champion of the world for the FISU Esports Challenge 2020, our inaugural tournament right here on FISU for Esports. So well done, Naj. And well done to all the girls, all 12 girls who competed.
Yeah.
Wonderful competition. She was dominant force, the rightful winner, and nothing but fantastic. And great to see Albrecki there also. For the men.
For the men, man.
Amran Adali from Modern College of Business and Science and Technology in Oman. The winner in the Golden Goal against Masih Mohafizatkar of has been Islamic Assad University in Iran, and Enriquez Gomes from all the way from down under in Australia, Swinburne University, the marketing graduate or the marketing student, hoping to be a business marketing graduate.
That's it, Ben. We're done for the first FISU eSports Challenge. Thank you so much, guys, for being here with us. Don't forget to follow us here on Twitch. There are some links below. Just have to scroll down a little bit and then you'll find our other social medias. Let's keep in touch. I'm Paulo Salvador. You can find me on Instagram as well. Thank you so much for that. That was a pleasure, Ben. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Ben Ibrahim, everyone.
Yeah.
Instagram. I'm Ben Ibrahim _ at Instagram. Yeah. I check Instagram regularly. Stay in touch.
Yeah.
Get some rest.
Get some rest.
And you are all.
On the next opportunity. That's it, Ben.